This is First Contact, Stories of the Call Center.
It's really unfortunate that the exploiting people when they're most vulnerable. You can think of everything from whenever there's massive hurricanes or any type of disasters. There's always going to be people saying, hey, we're collecting money to help people in this space. We're trying to get you something, to get you services. Obviously, right now with COVID-19, that's another piece. You have even people talking about right now that people are exploiting the Black Lives Matter movement. There's a lot of things right now that where there is passion, where there is pain, where there is concern, where there's money to be made, these bad actors go in there. So outside of some of the things you put in place, do you have any recommendations or specific things that a call originator could do to help protect their legitimate, important communication when they know they're going through a sea of a lot of bad actors that are exploiting such terrible things that are going on?
Especially for those in the survey and charity organizations that have been operating before all of this, the only thing and the most important thing that you can do right now is to register your numbers, go through a verification and vetting service such as the one that Numerical has. And that's your way of saying, I am who I say I am. These are legitimate calls. I do have consent. And that information gets distributed down to the carriers and app providers who are making decisions. And it allows them to do a separation. You're trying to filter the good from the bad. And if you can provide more information to them that I am the good guy, then they know what it looks like. They understand the traffic and the patterns versus the bad guys. And hopefully we really are dependent upon the terminating providers to then present that information to the subscriber. Numerical does not control, nor do we want to control what the terminating providers and app providers present to subscribers, but consumers can demand to have certain information presented to them.
So really, when it comes down to letting yourself be known, we've also seen that watching out, one, how you manage your number inventory, how you use your phone numbers, and separately your dialing strategy, how do you actually manage your dialing practices, those in combination with you being visible is really going to be helpful for you to, like you said, separate yourself. But would you say there's a silver bullet, a magic switch, or a wand that you flip and it just all goes away? Or would you say that you actually have to be constantly on top of this, aware, and putting a multi-tactic approach to be able to help address some of these things or mitigate, at minimum, some of the challenges?
Christian, you are hitting like my soapbox. I set it up here. We see success and failure from our clients on the same platform. So I have to go, what's the difference here? Why do some of our clients succeed and really succeed well, and others are just tanking? Their contact rates aren't going anywhere. It's all about their strategy, what you mentioned. It is a combination of number hygiene, who your partners are that provide you numbers, that put your calls on the network. It's all the players involved, how you present yourself to the network, honestly, your behavior on the network, and then ultimately to consumers, because the consumer can file complaints. So it could be maybe your messaging that once the consumer hears doesn't align with what they understood their relationship was with you. So it comes across suspect. Boom, they're going to complain about it. So that might be something that you need to do with your messaging. We've seen that. It could also be the number management. If you're using a TN provider who is sitting there rotating numbers because everybody is rotating numbers, you might be picking up numbers that are hot, meaning they were just used for some other campaign and whoop, they're coming over here going, sure, yeah, it's a fresh number to you, but it's not fresh to the network. So you inherit the bad behaviors. So you got to have a good partner who also manages the services that they provide. Another element is, constantly swapping out to try to hide behind spam. I'm sorry, the whack-a-mole approach is not going to work for you, and you can scream at me all day long that you want it to. It's not going to do anything. So, there's a lot of emotion around number management, and I think it really, you need to have good partners and good vendors who can offer up additional strategies and the types of calls that you're delivering. Another thing that I hate to say, but it could be a reality, perhaps the type of message that you're delivering across this particular number that you're using consumers just don't want that message over that over a call. You know, that's something we need to consider as well, and not force the consumer to use the channel. Let consumers use the channel of choice. Ultimately, you just want to get a message to them that moves them to do something. So be aware of that.
Yeah, those are all great points. And I think we've seen with our customers as well is, you know, if you just want to get a brand new number every single hour and just use it, throw it away, like as if they're just little like tissues, you're creating part of the problem for yourself. And we've also seen, and I think you've stated before really well, is if you use the same phone number for like 15 different things, or if you're an outsourcer for different clients and you're sharing these numbers across a bunch of different reasons and purposes and complaints, that also causes problems for people. So you really have to be able to align with someone who knows how to align each of these tactics in a way that acts as an aggregate to give you a better position in mitigating some of this pain versus just throwing stuff at it and hoping for the best. Because there are unfortunately a lot of people that do that, that just say, I just want a quick fix and move on. And the reality is, like you said, that's why you see the disparity between performance and non-performance.